Chapter 26. Essay Writing. Definition. Essay is a written composition which gives expression to one's own personal ideas. It can give information on any given subject.
Kinds of essays. Descriptive essays. A descriptive essay describes specific places, persons, things. Narrative essays. A narrative essay narrates events, visits, journeys, sports, events, stories, legends, and biographies. Reflective essays. A reflective essay deals with abstract concepts like habits, feelings, social topics, qualities, etc. Imaginative essays. An imaginative essay deals with wishes, life stories of things, adventures of some animal or human, etc.
An essay should be organized as follows. An essay should have an introduction.
The body of the essay should include supporting paragraphs.
It should have a conclusion. Example, descriptive essay.
Gods on land, Uttarakhand. In the lower and middle Himalayas, abutting Nepal and China on the eastern borders, lies the Indian state of Uttarakhand.
The state is divided into two administrative divisions, Garhwal and Kumaon. Kumaon was ruled by the Shah dynasty till the British annexed the territories after the Anglo-Gorkha wars in the early 19th century. The British found the natural splendor and strategic location of Kumaon enchanting and useful. They developed a string of picturesque summer retreats here and built roads, dams, barrages, rest houses, sanatoriums, etc. in the region. Later, after independence, these hill stations and towns saw an influx of migrants, mostly rich people seeking a piece of heaven for themselves.
Land prices rocketed. Business flourished. Population and congestion increased.
And these attractive little spots became bustling hubs of tourism, local trade, education, and a host of cottage and small-scale industries. Large-scale industries are being promoted in certain non-hilly regions of the state like Dehradun, Haridwar, Pantnagar, Khatima, and Rudrapur. Nainital, Mussoorie, Almora, and Ranikhet have some of the best schools in the country. Dehradun boasts of the famed Indian Military Academy, IMA, the Forest Research and Petroleum Research Institutes, as also the Wadia Institute of Himalayan Geology.
The Salwan environs of Garhwal lured such a renowned literature as Ruskin Bond into residing permanently at Mussoorie.
Stephen Alter, the noted travel writer and social activist, has made these hills his home, as has Tom Alter, his actor's son. The region's popularity as a tourist and investment destination lies in its proximity to New Delhi, India's capital city.
Lush green hills, magnificent lakes, simple but sumptuous cuisine, stepped cultivation, luscious fruits grown locally, beekeeping and honey production are some geocultural and economic features of the region which set it apart from other parts of the country.
Add to this a rich and varied cultural legacy, folk music, folk dance and a rich dialect, Kumaoni Garhwali. You have the recipe for a land and its people which earned it the sobriquet, God's own land. Example, imaginative essay, A Borderless World. The concept of the world being a global village is a much discussed one in recent times. With the advent of new technologies in communication, transportation, electronic computing, and internet, distances have already vanished and national borders blurred. Is the idea of the world as a single political, cultural, religious, and economic entity, a single global nation to be realized in the near future? Is this concept logically possible and acceptable to the peoples of the many countries that exist today as independent, sovereign and fiercely protective islands? What if such a grand fusion does happen in the near future? The scenario then would be something like this. The world will have a single currency, no currency conversion, no trade hassles, no product dumping. In other words, nobody would be saddled with surpluses and none would live in want. Technology would be available to all. That is, people in remote Malawi will have access to the same technical, medical, educational and nutritional resources that the United States has today. Wars will automatically end. Reason, there will not be any enemy country. As a result, all resources and efforts currently being funneled into defense establishments would be used for the welfare of the world citizens. Travel restrictions, visa requirements, green and sundry cards would not be needed, and one would go to the nearest airport, buy a flight ticket and hop onto a flight to reach any place in the world. A global nation would also ensure an end to cultural, communal and religious intolerance so rife today.
Just imagine the many benefits that a world nation would give its citizens. Think of the progress we, the citizens of Earth, will make. Only if the boundaries of some 190 plus countries dissolve to have one global name and flag.